Please stay. The entrance in upon God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that all who believe in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, as we join together, not only on this fifth day of the Octave of Christmas, but also on the feast day of St. Thomas Becket, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord Jesus, your mighty God, Prince of Peace, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Word made flesh, the splendor of the Father, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you. We adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who gave the martyr St. Thomas Becket the courage to give up his life for the sake of justice, grant through his intercession that renouncing our life for the sake of Christ in this world, we may find it in heaven. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, the way we make sure that we know Jesus is to keep his commandments. Whoever says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments, is a liar and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. This is the way we may know that we are in union with him. Whoever claims to abide in him, ought to walk just as he walked. Beloved, I am writing no new commandment to you, but an old commandment that you had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word that you have heard. And yet I do write a new commandment to you, which holds true in him and among you. For the darkness is passing away, and the true light is already shining. Whoever says he is in the light, yet hates his brother, is still in the darkness. Whoever loves his brother remains in the light, and there is nothing in him to cause a fall. Whoever hates his brother is in darkness. He walks in darkness and does not know where he's gone, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. The Lord made the heavens. Splendor and majesty go before him. Praise and grandeur are in his sanctuary. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, two interesting things happened this morning in my haste of trying to wake up and get myself going after all these Christmas masses we just celebrated. The first was trying to figure out exactly why I wasn't supposed to wear red on a few martyrs' feast day. But it comes down to the fact that unless we're actually, it is a truly celebrated feast, and this morning it's an optional memorial, Christmas supersedes. So hence, I'm back in white in the Christmas red vestment here. But the second part was an interesting thing. A priest friend of mine texted me along and saying, are you seeing this? And it was this morning, or yesterday rather, that something came out of the White House literally celebrating this feast day of all things. And I started to read and going, okay, well, this is not a proclamation I'm used to seeing coming out of any kind of political realm. But it was basically telling the story of St. Thomas Becket, and his, again, this whole idea of his courage and stand in the midst of trial. Because when we look at St. Thomas's life, St. Thomas didn't start out again in the realm of being a priest or even a bishop. He started out in the service of King Henry II. He started out serving in this way, again, being one of the smartest people in the kingdom, and Henry recognized it, and that was basically his way forward. It wasn't until the Archbishop of Canterbury basically retired that Henry exercised a little bit of his, again, authority at the time and said, oh, Thomas, you can go do that, right? So Thomas stepped into the role. But it was then to the king's detriment, because as he stepped into the role, that gift of grace starts to work. And again, this is where Thomas started to take a stand against all the things that Henry was kind of, again, trying to take over during the course of everything. It got to the point that Henry was so frustrated with Thomas because his right-hand man as the chancellor had now become the biggest thorn in his side. That as the saying goes, he said, won't anybody rid me of this crazy priest or something to that effect? Well, his knights took that as basically an invitation. And again, they burst into his church and to his cathedral where he was fully, again, all ready to go for mass, full vestments, the whole nine yards. And they ultimately took his life. But it was because of Henry's overreach into the realm of church affairs all the time that Thomas kept holding steady and would not yield. It's a recognition of this gift that we have in the midst of everything. Is this, again, worth giving it all for? Is it worth is our faith worth more than what we would just say is this, you know, passing glimpse of everything? Because God has given us the truth in the person of Jesus Christ. When it affects us in our deepest part of our person, it changes things. As it changed for St. Thomas. And it gave, again, he gave so much of himself that he gave his very life, the upholding of that truth. It was so much so that after the fact, when the knights had kind of again done their deed and everything else, Henry kind of came to this recognition and basically allowed himself to go through public repentance and turn his heart back to God. And again, at least for that time, up until Henry VIII, England remained in that gift of Catholicism. Do we then have the courage, those in our life that we are now seeing that maybe are drifting away from the faith, to be those faithful witnesses? That doesn't mean we bludgeon with the truth or weaponize the truth, but we hold to it in the midst of a world full of trials. It's so easy to allow ourselves to just let it go by us, to say it's someone else's problem, to not fight the good fight, if you will, of living out the principles of our faith and saying that they're worth holding on to. It's so much easier to yield. But yet our Lord looks at all of us, as he looked at the saints of old and all those through the ages, and saying again, those who have saved their life would lose it, but those who lose their life for my sake would find it. We find our fullness in our person in Jesus Christ himself. So with that in mind, on this great feast day of St. Thomas Becket, let us ask for his intercession and that gift of grace that we need to be courageous in these times. As we pray, St. Thomas Becket, pray for us. trust in our Lord and Savior, we now bring our prayers before you this day. That the witness of Holy Simeon may make us attentive to the coming of our Savior, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the devout and holy may behold the fulfillment of what God has promised, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the wisdom of our elders may guide families and communities in the way of caring and respect, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the Spirit may guide all gathered here in our search of the Holy One, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that those pierced by illness and anxiety may find hope in the bright dawn of Christ's presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that on this feast day of St. Thomas Becket, we may find a new gift of courage in our hearts, bestowed by Christ, to uphold the tenets of the faith, whether in season or out of season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the dead may find welcome in eternal peace of God's promise to his faithful servants. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and to remember Dick Pendleton in the prayer of this liturgy, let us also offer up our own prayers to the Lord in the silence of our own hearts. We pray to the Lord. Good and gracious God, we ask for your abundant grace and mercy to be poured into our hearts on this feast day of St. Thomas Becket, that with the gift of courage, we may uphold the gift that you give us, Lord, the gift of faith, the gift of hope, and the gift of charity, always keeping our eyes focused on you, who have loved us first. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And in order to set us aside by the city of hands, for the praise and glory of Son's name, what our Lord and the Lord of all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through him the holy exchange that restores our life has shone forth today in splendor, when our frailty is assumed by your word. Not only does human mortality receive honor and honor, but by this wondrous union we too are made eternal. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you who held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity, in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the
sins of
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We have been the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present, the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, humbly spiritually into my heart, I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. our life may be constantly sustained. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We now pray together the prayer of St. Michael. St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you, the humbly pray. Do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, the power of God, cast about Satan and all evil spirits, proud about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.